You're here on GladRap Channel as the cameraman almost fell over the plants. We've got the one and only, I'm going to say how Dan Hennessy once said it, Julius Long!
Wow. Hey, how's it going, guys? The GladRap. It's always a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, we always have so much fun, especially when we go to Dan Hennessy's house, we have a few drinks, especially that, what was it, the bachelor party. We don't talk about that in front of the wife, though. We don't talk about that.
none of that. Can't do that. We talk about the chicken wings, though, and all the good food.
The chicken wings. We love those chicken wings.
Yeah, the good snacks. You know, I'm a certified chef here, too, you know. So I'm constantly putting my hands to work in the ring and outside the ring.
That was always so much fun, like those parties that we always end up going to. I think we had a party where we was watching a Junior Fa at one point, and then one of his fights or something like that.
Yeah, Junior Fa is an upcoming talent right now, but going in there against Joseph Parker, fighting on the undercard against Hemi the Heat. We're waiting for him to bring the heat as usual. We hope he brings the heat. We've never seen the heat.
More lukewarm.
Like more lukewarm. Exactly. But, you know, I'm here again for another day, you know. And the reason why I'm getting this shot to be in the ring again is because what I did to David, what's his name, David, who cares about what his name is anymore? He was Shane Cameron's big prodigy. They thought he was going to be the next big thing, but I shut all that up, you know.
Oh, Kiki Toilatelli.
Yeah, I shut all that stuff up, you know. All that bullcrap nonsense. It's out the door, you know.
you show like, when you're really in it, you're really in it. And yeah, you could actually really take anyone on, and especially like someone like Lucas Brown and Boy Tupua.
Yeah, you know, at my age, you know, I'm like a... Like Makembe Mutombo said, they wrote his age on a tree and they cut the tree down so he doesn't know how old he is. I just keep going, you know what I mean? The people in New Zealand is my strength, you know? I do it for them. I don't do it for the people that at the corporate tables, the people who buy the $1 million seats. I do it for the people that's the collar workers, to buy the $20 seats and sit up in the bleachers, you know what I mean? The mentally challenged kids, the disabled people. I do it for those people. That's what I fight for, you know?
And plus, if anyone tries to knock you down, you'll slap them with your branch.
Yeah, I got 90 inches to reach here, you know what I mean? So I'm the tallest fighter in the world. You know, I bring a lot to the table, you know what I mean? And so that's why I'm on this undercard, you know what I mean? It's not just because of the COVID thing and the epidemic and all that. You know, I'm here for a real reason and fighting on this show because of who I am, you know?
Now, this is probably the lightest I've actually seen you in a long time coming into this fight.
Wow, that's weird. I thought I was the heaviest I've ever been, but I feel great, you know. That's the main thing. It could be at any weight you want to really be, you know what I mean, as long as you feel great, you know what I mean. And that's one thing I do. No matter what it is, you might see me on the street doing or partying or whatever. When it comes to the fight and I sign the contract, I take it seriously and I always do it and bite down and do everything I possibly can do to get into shape. Whether it's on a week's notice, whether it's on a 3 days notice, I never shy away from any type of fight, you know what I mean? I'm a warrior. You know, chicks dig scars, wounds heal.
Where'd that wife go?
Yeah.
She would know!
Yeah, I'm probably going to get a black eye for the chicks still. Yeah. Cars. But it is what it is. I'll probably get more black eyes from my own daughter at night.
So leading into this fight, how's training been?
Training's been good, you know. The family's been letting me get out and do what I had to do, you know. Just positive thoughts all around the house. The wife's constantly kicking me in the butt and telling me I need to go train, you know. I'm constantly getting calls from my daughter over in the States, Malia. She's been... really supporting me and everything, and my daughter Ambria, she's been supporting me. So with those kids giving me the blessing to constantly get in the ring, I'm constantly creating opportunities for them. I know at my age right now, I've did everything all over the world, you know what I mean? It's all about creating opportunities for them, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. So you fought Hemi Ahio a couple of years ago now. On the world title undercard with Giovanna and Lani Daniels.
Yeah, that was a nice one. I like Giovanna. She's got something special, man.
It's unfortunately that she has officially retired now, but she's going into kickboxing now herself.
Wow. Well, I'll be still front row center for some of those fights, you know what I mean? I love to see that, you know what I mean? She's a vicious opponent out there in any sport that she's going to do. She's going to be great at it, you know what I mean? So, women's boxing here in New Zealand is so overlooked, and I never overlook women's boxing because I believe they're truly great and they bring a lot to the sport.
So, what are you going to do different in this fight compared to your last fight with Hemi?
Well, I was a lot of overweight, in that fight. I had my mom here. It was around COVID time and everything. So I still went finished on my feet. And the main thing, I made the fight interesting still. It still was a point there where it looked like I could have won the fight. So this time I'm in a lot more better shape. They think I'm bringing the same thing. They team always thinking that I'm going to do this and do that. I'm always the person that does the complete opposite and surprises people. So I know his team, he's been probably sparring with Junior Fire, but do I care? Junior Fire's not me. You know, you can get anybody you want to perform and try to be like Julius, but they're not Julius Long. You know, they're not 7'1". They're not going to move like Julius because they don't know how to move like Julius. And most fighters over here don't teach defense. They just teach offense. I'm cut from a whole different type of cloth of fighters, you know what I mean? I grew up with the Thomas Hearns, the Marvis Hagelers, the Sugar Ray Leonards, the Frank Brunos, all the mean guys, the real collar workers that, like me, I work hard every day, a real job. I'm not getting no promoter out here feeding me, nothing like that. I don't have a management. I'm self-managed, you know what I mean? I'm self-trained. If I don't go to the gym, it's because I don't go to the gym. I force myself to go to the gym to do everything. And that's the best way to have it. So if when you go into the ring, if you don't do right, you can only fight yourself. Yeah. And that's how I like it. Because when you inside the ring, you inside the ring by yourself. You can't call somebody else in for a substitution to take that ass whooping. Yeah. You know what I mean? That's just bottom line. You would like somebody. You know?
Not me. I don't want to be fighting anytime soon. You'll kick my ass.
Can I get a substitution in for this ass beating?
Josh! He's going to kick my ass!
You just can't call boxing. You can't have a substitution for boxing like that. You know what I mean? Any other sport, football or whatever, you get tired, you can call in a substitution. You can't call a substitution in for boxing. That's it, you know?
I love the confidence. I always love confidence in boxing. It's kind of like when you're trying to date someone, you want confidence. You have the confidence in the ring, and that's the main thing.
At the end of the day, man, he can bring all the heat he wants and shit. He got two fucking hands just like me. You know what I mean? I come from Detroit, where the motherfuckers got guns and knives and all that stuff and walk up to you on the street, and if you don't give them no pocket change, you might get stabbed. So what the fuck I give a fuck about the heat? You know?
Now, not only are you the tallest boxer in the world, I think you got the best mouth and ways of promo work. You definitely know how to sell a camera. Now, I'm going to get you to do something that I've been asking all the boxers.
Right, oh, no, don't do that.
I'm going to get you to look into that camera. I'm going to get you to take this microphone, go all WWE, and tell us what you're going to do to Hemi Ahio.
That's right, buddy. Tomorrow night, when it comes on, and I get you in the ring, you ain't gonna have to worry about no heat, because I'm gonna bring some oil for you and a little cooking grease, and I'm gonna turn up the heat. And I got a couple of pies in my bag I want you to warm up, because when the heat comes down, I'm the Tower Inferno. I bring the real heat.
Julius, the towering